Hi, I was reading a book about healing with Reiki by the Japanese art of laying hands upon another person or oneself and curing the person that way. So I have some own experience about curing by laying hands upon, and those are connected to meditation, how meditation is your natural way of functioning. Your kind of sense yourself as in a natural way that is also a guide to your functioning. And by touching the other person in Reiki or in other wise, you kind of, via social contact, inform the other one of your way of living. And this way, the good side of your way of living spread to the other one as an insight about how to live. And also, if you yourself do not fully know how to live, but you have some good sides to your being, like you are friendly and pray for good things to happen and for the world to become a good place to live in and such things. So there's something good in your way of living, and that gives the other person, the patient, a possibility via your contact to live more fully in ways that are natural for humans. And those natural ways of living are also curing ones. They make you healthy and start the natural curing mechanisms of your body and mind, which are connected. Like if you feel stuck, your neck and shoulders are tense and so on. So that stops you from experiencing life fully, also in the physical level. And thus you kind of may have some headache or something of the kind, which is related to your tension in the neck. So your freedom of living a natural, healthy kind of life creates for you bodily expressions of your state of mind. And if those bodily expressions are very unhealthy, if your state of mind is unhealthy, it's connected to unhealthy ways of keeping your body, for example, too tense. So you get pains and you may get ill. But if you manage to reach a healthy state of mind with kind of healthy kind of contact with the world at large, so and also friendly kind of healthy kind of social life, so then you have a chance of functioning properly in every respect, and that is also in your body, which kind of is not strained because of your state of mind, but instead gets support from your mental sides, works together with them, with the mental sides harmoniously, so that you can get cured or live healthily and happily in a light, non-forcing way. So I think that via this kind of view, there's a scientific explanation for how these life energies work. Life energy is our natural way of observing human life and social contacts. Like it's connected to things like social space, emotional space, which are agreed, like this teacup is mine, so I keep it close to me, and that is yours, so I keep it far away, and I keep myself turned towards my teacup, if that's somehow the center of attention when I'm drinking tea. So in all kinds of things you show which things are your area, which are yours and which are somebody else's. So this kind of space around the body can be observed by observing the atmosphere of the situation and by observing your posture, so you can, without asking, know which teacup is whose, and also about other things, of course. And so life energy is typically described as some kind of flow which comes either from heaven or from the hands of the other one or from the whole body of the other one, and its surrounding emotional and social space. And that's the way we observe our body if we are relaxed, totally like in a summer weather, or if you put your hands to warm water, you can feel it, some kind of tingling in your fingers. So your feelings tell that it is some kind of lines or movement coming out of the fingers. And it's not your sense of sight. Typically, if you use only your sense of sight, you get a different picture, which is the one used in science. But if you listen to your sensations, you may feel the possibilities of movement of your hand to different directions. And those are kind of a flow outward from the hand. And you can also... Koira! Sorry about that interruption. You can also think of your posture with the help of this flow. It comes from down, from where you are supported, up to where which is supported. It's kind of your way of correcting your posture. That way you can understand some side of it. So we are this natural, functional way of looking at human life and social life. You can see your intentions forming some kind of lines from you and your eyes, your hands toward the objects which you are going to touch. You kind of can observe in the atmosphere, in your sensations, this connection of yourself with the object that interests you really much. And those are just life energy as a flow. And in social contact, you get influence of the other person's way of doing, where they contact with you, where they guess the language, and via touch via which you can feel the state of the other one, other one's state of mind, and kind of, how to say, bodily expressions of their state of mind, and also the tones of voice of the other one express what the state of mind is. So that gets spread from the other person towards you, also, especially if you are in close contact. So like if you are with friends with someone, so you sit side by side and look at the same things and do things in the same ways. So you are kind of one entity, energetically, at that time. But you kind of share the same way of living, so your auras touch in a way, they form one entity. But of course you are still yourself and the other one is himself or herself, of course. So there's this separation still, both having their own auras, of course, all the time. But some sides of your lives are similar at that moment, so you're kind of forming a group. This way, I think, is a scientifically correct way of looking at auras and healing by hands. Thank you. Bye.